what you're watching in front. Got a source of light here, and this is a convex lens which I am going to insert inside. So what happens is it will bring all the light rays together, right? Now you can see here light is scattered. So when I keep this here in this way, I get a thick beam of light. I still want a beam of light to be narrow, because this is what we require for our demonstration. And here we get, I'm keeping it a bit straight here so that it is in your view properly. I hope you are watching this properly now. Now this will give you a glare, that's why I'm going to cover this here. Well, I can even take three light rays using another slit. Here it is, and I get three of the light rays here. By moving this lens, I can rearrange the lines so that they are moving parallel to each other. Look at this. So I want light rays which are parallel. When the light fall on a plane mirror, as you have seen in the previous experiments, they reflect. You can watch this reflection now. I'm bringing it so close. All these are incident rays. They are parallel to each other. They fall on this plane mirror and they reflect. And look at the reflected rays. They also move parallel. And this kind of reflection is called regular reflection, because you see here, if this is the incident ray, for this incident ray, this is the reflected ray. For this incident ray, this is the reflected ray. And for this incident ray, this is the reflected ray. The light always follows a rule: angle of incidence has to be equal to angle of reflection. And that is why when they come parallel, they'll move parallel. Keep this in the mind. As you turn this slightly, the angle between them becomes smaller and smaller. And then, if you make an arrangement of light in such a way that if they fall straight onto the plane of the mirror, this is the plane of the mirror, and then they reflect back. In this case, angle of incidence and angle of reflection is zero. I'm showing it again. Now, angle of incidence and angle of reflection has some value now. It is going to be zero when incident ray strikes right on the plane of the mirror at right angles. So it goes back in the same direction, right? This is the speciality of the plane mirror. I'm going to introduce two more mirrors here, right in front of you. And you can watch closely here. This particular mirror appears little bulged in the front. Look at this. And this is the mirror which is curved inside. They are as if a part of a big spear. If you can imagine a huge spear, and if you can cut one side, then you get that type of mirror here. That's why, since they are part of a spear, these mirrors are called spherical mirrors. They are not plane on their surfaces. This one is bulged upward, whereas this is what is curved inward. These are not plane mirrors like this. So these mirrors are called spherical mirrors, remember. And how we can draw these spherical mirrors, that we shall see separately. Now, as I have told you that a plane mirror reflects back all the lights here. In opposite direction, if the incident rays fall at right angles to each other, whereas now I am going to take a concave mirror. This is what is called concave mirror. A mirror which is curved inward is called concave mirror, right? And if you cut that mirror exactly half, I get this. So that I can place this properly facing this mirror. Even I can insert here, no problem, but it doesn't go here, right? So some arrangement is made. We have cut this properly here. This is a concave mirror and this is a concave mirror. Remember, I am going to keep a concave mirror, concave, right in front of the three parallel incident rays. Now look at this closely, right? Look at this closely. These rays, particularly this particular rays, hits here and goes in this direction. You see this? Okay, I can bring it here. Look at this. They are coming closer, right? So I'll bring it here back. And I'm going to put off the light now. And now you can see this. This is the incident ray. While reflection, it bent in this way. This also is bending. So, after reflection, these light rays which are parallel are coming closer and they meet at this particular point, right? So, this is speciality of concave mirror, which is curved downward. I am bringing it here. See, look at this. On reflection, light rays are coming closer and they meet at a particular point. Now I'll take it back and bring this convex mirror. Convex, it is curved upward. And I have a convex mirror with me now, here, and look at this. This mirror doesn't bring the light closer, they move away. So remember, convex mirror on reflection moves the light away from it. Right? They come parallel to each other here, but they go away. Whereas concave mirror brings them closer. Look at this. And these right rays meet here. Convex mirror, they do not meet, they go away. So this type of reflection is called divergence. Remember this. What is this called? Divergence. Convex mirror diverges the light. And concave mirror converges the light. This is called convergence. Right? So this is convergence and this is divergence. I am purposely repeating this time and again so that you should be familiar to this. I am going to conclude now. When I keep a plane mirror, light rays moves in the same direction. When I keep the spherical mirror, it doesn't happen. Let me keep this concave mirror, light rays comes closer to each other and they meet at a particular point. So this phenomena is called converging of light. And which mirror? This is a concave mirror, and this concave mirror, since it is converging the light rays, we can call it as a converging mirror, right? And then I am bringing a convex mirror. So it diverges the light. Diverges means light goes away, right? So it is a diverging mirror. Convex mirror is diverging mirror. Now, how will you draw these diagrams? That is more important, because when it comes to exam, you should be familiar with the knowledge of drawing. In the next, we shall have now a simple demonstration right on this base. I am going to take it out, the source of light, keep it aside, and also the base. Now what I want to do is keep a plane mirror right on this screen. Now let us suppose that this is a plane mirror. This is not exactly a plane mirror. It's just a stick. And let us suppose that this is a plane mirror and these are the incident rays, right? So they have come and hit the plane mirror. This is the second light ray. This is the third light ray. And this is the fourth light ray. Just imagine, right? These light rays, they are all incident rays. Just like you have seen in the video, the light have come and fallen on the plane mirror. Let's assume that. And what will happen? Each of these light will reflect back because they have incidented, fallen on this plane mirror at 90 degree here. So when the light ray falls at 90 degree on this plane mirror, they reflect back. Okay, now I'm going to keep another set of light rays which are only of reflected rays. These are all incident rays. So I am going to remove this and I'm keeping another arrangement here which will show you only reflected rays. Right? These are all reflected rays. You can see this little far here. These are all reflected rays. Now, in case if I make this plane mirror a concave mirror, and how can I make? I can bend this. This is possible here. Now if I bend it, now just see what is going to happen for all these reflected rays. Look at this. Are they not coming closer? And what does this mirror represents now? This mirror represents a concave mirror, right? In the same way, again it's a plane mirror. And if I bend it this way, it's a convex mirror. Let me show it once again. This is a plane mirror. Reflected rays have gone straight in opposite direction of the incident ray. And in case if this is a concave mirror is the mirror which is curved inward, And now what happens, you see? All these reflected rays are coming near. This is what the convergence of light in the concave mirror. And they meet at one particular point. And remember, even on this concave mirror, when the reflection takes place, light follows loss of reflection. That is, angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. And what is the difference? Only plane is the difference. Here it is curved, whereas in the plane mirror it is straight. And now we shall see how can we draw these diagrams.
Well, now we shall work out how to draw the ray diagram. Right in front of you is a concave mirror. And what is concave mirror? The mirror which is curved inwards, right? And we have already seen the demonstration of the light ray falling on the concave mirror, right? Now, in this animation, you will find not only two rays, many rays are fallen on the concave mirror on every side, all around, right? We had taken in the demonstration only two rays, but practically it doesn't happen. Many light rays will fall on the concave mirror and then they reflect back. Okay, and when they reflect back, they will pass through a single point, right? And that is what is called convergence of light. But remember, if a light ray which falls on the plane mirror in the center, that light ray will reflect back in the opposite direction along the same line, right? And rest all the other light rays will bend, or we can say converge. We can turn this animation 90 degrees and see here in a different angle. When the light falls on concave mirror, it reflects and then they converge and pass through a single point, right? Except the one which is in the center, and we will talk on that, why it happens so. Now we have to draw a ray diagram. And what should we have to draw the ray diagram? A notebook and compass box, mainly a scale, right? Now here I want you to pause the video and pick up your compass box as well as notebook and be ready along with the instructions given in the video. You have to draw, and that will be good practice for you. And here we go. What we have to do is take help of the lines of a notebook. Already you find lines there. So make use of that. Use your scale and draw a straight line. Now we should have a protractor. With the help of protractor, we have to draw the curve. Keep protractor properly and draw the curve. And why did we draw the curve? Because that is the curve we are converting it to a concave mirror. Now bring back the scale. Let us draw incident ray. Now, instead of drawing so many incident rays, let us take only one incident ray. And again here, you have to make use of the line which is already there on your notebook. And draw incident ray. And when you draw incident ray, remember, you have to end that ray with the arrow mark. Look at this here. there is an arrow mark, and then only we can call this as a light ray, or else it is simply a line. And where this will reflect, we have seen in the demonstration as well as in the animation that it converges. It will reflect inward. And so we have to keep our scale and draw the reflected ray. And again, when you draw the reflected ray, show an arrow mark on that reflected ray. Let us take one more incident ray at the bottom. And here we have to draw again an incident ray, just like as how we have drawn on the top. And that incident ray falls on the concave mirror and reflect, right, backward. And when it reflects, it has to follow law of reflection. Now, is our scale properly placed? No, not at all. We have to place it properly, because we know that reflected ray of both these lines will pass through a single point. Point to be noted here that the light rays which are parallel, understood, they have passed through a single point. We'll come back to this discussion a little later. Right? Now, this is what the diagram for convergence of light rays in the concave mirror. You can draw only two light rays, not so many light rays as it was shown in the animation. The point where these two rays meet is called principal focus of concave mirror. This is the concave mirror. Remember this. This is a very important concept. So what is principal focus of concave mirror? The point where the light rays meet here, right on your screen. The center of the mirror here is called pole. And if you can find an axis there, this is the axis which passed through. It's not a ray. We call it as an axis, and we'll referring it as principal axis. Right? And why we need principal axis now? We need principal axis to refer these incident rays. Now I can tell incident rays which are parallel to the principal axis, this is principal axis, reflect back and pass through single point on the principal axis. I hope you have understood. So if you can draw this much, this is the diagram for convergence of light rays in the concave mirror. Suppose if a question is define principal focus, what you have seen in the previous slide is a principal focus. And if the question is define principal focus of concave mirror with the help of diagram, then you have to draw the same diagram and write at the bottom. You can read here, light rays parallel to the principal axis. These two are the light rays which are parallel to the principal axis. On reflection, they pass through a single point on principal axis. And this point is called as principal focus. So this is the answer for a definition of principal focus of concave mirror with the help of diagram. Right? In the next video, we shall see how can we define principal focus of convex mirror.